everyone, I am Rohit and welcome to my YouTube channel AIAM. So guys, in this particular video, I am going to create a classification machine learning model that will predict a wine quality. So before moving towards our Jupyter Notebook, I would like to tell you that I am created a video on Pandas library as well as on NumPy library. So if you want to learn a data science, or in future if you want to become data science, then start with both these library. Will give you initial confidence. So it's my humble request to you to please access those library and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era, and press this bell icon and never miss an any update. So the main motto of today's video is to create a machine learning model that will predict a wine quality. Therefore, we require a wine quality dataset. As from previous video, we download our dataset from Kaggle website. In this video, we also download our dataset from same website such as Kaggle. So in Kaggle website, here is my dataset, that is red wine quality dataset. So by clicking on download button, I can download it, the dataset. So just I simple click it on this download button, and you can see over here the dataset is get downloaded. The next step is to store a dataset in our PC at a particular folder. The link of this dataset is given in the description below. So you also can access this dataset for your further reference or for your practice. So after downloading this dataset, I can store it in my folder, and by using OOS library, I can choose my dataset from a particular folder or access my dataset from that location. So without doing any delay, just jump into a Jupyter Notebook. So guys, here I am in my Jupyter Notebook. So before starting, the first step is to start any machine learning algorithm or creating any machine learning model is to import a necessary library. My necessary library contains my pandas, my numpy, also a data visualization library such as matplotlib, seaborn, os library, and sklearn library. So in the first cell, I have to import pandas as pd. The pandas library is basically used to read a dataset. Import numpy as np. A numpy library is used to perform a mathematical operation. Numpy library is handle a various kind of mathematical operation. A matplotlib library is to generate and visualize the dataset. Also, we import a seaborn library as sns to generate graphs and visualize the dataset. We use a os library to change or select a particular working directory. So here I can save my dataset in E drive in pandas folder. So I can set my current working directory in E drive and pandas folder. Therefore, I can access my dataset very easily. So to execute this file, also before moving toward execution, I would like to tell you that in this first cell, I will also import my sklearn library. That sklearn library will provide me various kind of classifier. Also, you can just Google it, sklearn, and read a documentation. By reading this documentation, you also get information about various classifier that we use in our today's video. To execute this file or to execute this cell, we have to press and shift enter. In Jupyter Notebook, we basically press a shift enter or just click on this run button to execute our cell. When this asteroid is get converted into number, this my particular cell is get run successfully. Okay, you can see over here the square bracket shows the number 1. So the my first cell is get executed successfully, and the necessary library is imported successfully. So the next step is to import a dataset, and the dataset is imported by writing as df is equal to pd.read_csv, and in close parenthesis I will have to mention my dataset with its extension. Basically, in machine learning or in data science, we particularly use a comma separated value or .csv format for our dataset. Then to visualize the dataset, we just have to simply say df.head, and this command will show me first 5 rows of my dataset and its features. So I can execute this cell. So you can see over here, it will give me a first 5 rows and the feature. After that, I can print the information of my dataset So total 12 features are present in my dataset, and all features are non-null, means no missing value are present in my dataset. Also, it contains total 1599 entries, means total 1599 rows contains my dataset, and the memory uses my dataset is the 150 KB. After that, we didn't know my dependent variable, also my independent variable. So the main aim of our today's video is to predict quality of the wine. Therefore, I have to create a correlation matrix and find out the which variable which has a highly correlation value with my quality feature, and I can choose this variable as my input feature and my quality as my output feature. So to find correlation between variables, I can simply have to write a code df.correlation and close parenthesis. After that, I have to simply write t that will convert our correlation matrix into transpose matrix. And believe me guys, this when we convert our matrix into transpose matrix, this matrix is a readable as compared to without transpose matrix. So it is very good practice to convert our matrix into transpose matrix. Particularly, this note is applicable, very much applicable, when we create a correlation matrix. For execution this cell, I have to just press and shift enter. It shows me my feature and the correlation of my variable in this matrix. So first of all, the alcohol, which shows a large correlation with my quality input feature, my quality output feature, that is 0.476. After that, sulfate shows a 0.25, and after that my citric acid, which shows a 0.02263. So after that, we have to define our variable. Therefore, from correlation matrix, we know that the alcohol, sulfates and citric acid, which show a very good correlation with my output feature. Therefore, I can take as my input feature and quality as my output feature. To execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. To visualize a data, here I can create a joint plot by using a seaborne library. So first of all, I will create joint plot of two variable, that is alcohol and quality, then by sulfates and quality, and the last citric acid and quality. To just visualize our data, we create this graph. To execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. So you can see over here, we just created plot by simply saying SNS dot joint plot, and we have to give our X variable, that is alcohol, and Y variable, that is quality. We have to choose, or you can select any color, but I like the red color very much. Therefore, I can select color is red, and I select a kind, that is KD. KD is nothing but my kernel density estimator. So you can see over here, in alcohol it will show, and in Y axis it will show a quality. At a point over here, it shows a phi number. So I can say that at a quality of phi and an alcohol in between, ranges in between 9 to 10, it will have a large amount of data set. So same as we can create a joint plot, and the kind is a kernel density estimator, we can create a joint plot of sulfate and quality, and last one is citric acid and quality. So after data visualization, you can see over here, it will shows me a density of largely populated point. So you can visualize over here, the maximum point are in between 9 to 10 range of alcohol, and in quality it lies between 5 to 6. As same as you can read the next two graph, that is sulfate and quality, as well as citric acid and quality. So the next is create a classifier. So in last video, that is a diabetes prediction video, we can create a classifier using my multilayer perceptron classifier. Here we can choose, this is our first classifier. We can choose a many classifier in this lecture. This is our first classifier, and we can see how much accuracy it will give us. So to execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. I simply import my MLP classifier from sklearn.neuralnetwork, import MLP classifier, and I can initiate my classifier and save in the variable called CLF, and I can mention my hidden layer size, that is 100, and I can mention my activation is logistic. I can use a logistic activation function because I have to classify between various classes, and logistic function give me a binary output, that is 0 or either 1. So therefore I can use the activation function such as logistic. After that I have to feed the data set by simply saying clf.feed, that is x and y, where x is my variable, you can see over here, and y is my variable, that is quality. So we can train, test and split our data set. Therefore I can simply say from sklearn.model_selection import train test split, and I can train test split my data set, and I keep my test size is 0.25. I can predict my data set clf.predict and in close parenthesis extend, and I can save it in my variable called ypredict. After that I have to check my accuracy score. Okay, so MLP, multi-rare perceptron classifier, will give me a class accuracy of around 55%, and next is to create a classification report. Okay, so we can conclude that by seeing that accuracy score and classification report, the MLP classifier, it does not provide a very good result. So we have to move towards our next classifier called decision tree classifier to execute this particular cell. So in the first cell, I have to import my decision tree classifier by simply writing from sklearn.tree import decision tree classifier, and I have to press and shift enter. After that, I have to initialize my variable by saying clf.decisionTreeClassifier and fit my data. I create my predict variable by simply saying ypredict is equal to clf.predict and in close parenthesis x_train. And the next, I have to calculate my accuracy score. So guys, you can see over here, it will give me a 99% of accuracy. A decision tree classifier will give me a 99% of accuracy. The next is I have to print a classification report. Okay, also classification report also shows a very good result as compared to my MLP classifier. The next is select nearest neighbor classifier. So by same method, I have to import my KNN or nearest neighbor classifier by simply typing from sklearn.neighbors import kneighbors classifier. For import or to execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. Then I have to import or initialize my classifier by simply saying clf.kneighbors classifier, and I have to choose a hyperparameter such as number of neighbors is equal to 24. So here I can select a total number of neighbors, that is 24, and I can fit my dataset. After fitting my dataset, I have to generate a ypredict, and after that I have to check my accuracy. KNN algorithm or KNN model give me accuracy around a 61% or 60.96%. And the next is a support vector classifier. So from us sklearn.svm, import a support vector classifier. To importing or to execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. After that I have to fit my data and initialize my classifier. After initializing and fitting my data, I have to create my prediction variable, that is ypredict, by simply saying clf.predict, and in close parenthesis I have to give a value of x_train. And after that I can simply print accuracy score, and accuracy score, it will give me around a 0.56. Oh, it's very poor. It's closely to our the MLP classifier. From our three classifier, the only decision tree will give us highest result, that is highest accuracy score, that is 0.99%. And the second last is my SGD classifier, that is stochastic gradient descent classifier. So I can import it from sklearn by simply saying from sklearn.linearModel import SGD classifier, and I can initialize my classifier. After that I can fit my data. After fitting my data, I can create my predict variable, that is ypredict is equal to clf.predict, and in close parenthesis I will have to mention my extend dataset. After that I can print my accuracy score by simply importing accuracy score from sklearn.matrix. I can, by using this code, I can print my accuracy score. So very poor, it will give me only 0.46. so you can see guys, up till now our decision tree is on top of, as compared to as in the rank of accuracy score, decision tree algorithm or my decision tree classifier will give me 99% of accuracy, and no other than classifier will go on above the 60%. And the last classifier that we use in this today's video is known as random forest classifier. For importing this classifier, we can simply write from sklearn.ensemble import random forest classifier, and to execute this file I have to press and shift enter, and the next cell I have to initialize my classifier by simply saying clf is equal to random forest classifier, and I have to fit my dataset. After fitting my dataset, I have to predict my dataset. For prediction, I just simply say yPred is equal to clf.predict, and in close parenthesis I have to give the value of xpen, and after that I have to print the accuracy score. So random forest will give me accuracy score which is much closer to our decision tree accuracy score. It will give me a 96%, around a 97% of accuracy. So we can conclude that for a particular wine quality problem, my decision tree classifier will work very good, will work not only good, it will work excellently, and it will give me a result, a very good result. It will give me around a 99% of accuracy. Guys, this is enough for today's video. So if you like this video, please like it, share with your friend, and do subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era. And don't forget to press an bell icon and never miss any update. So if you want to give any suggestion, or if you feel that if something wrong with the video or something wrong with the tutorial, then please comment it out. Thank you one and all.